The solar system is ours. Let's take it. And that, of course, includes Mars. And for humans to be able to explore Mars together with us doing science, we need a better environment. Early on in its history, Mars had a significant amount of water, but it went through rapid climate change, and now it's a very arid planet. The solar wind after Mars perhaps lost its magnetic field early on in its history has been pounding Mars. We now know that Mars has lost between 80% and 90% of its atmosphere. How can we change this? How can we improve this environment? Well, if we let nature take its course, this might be more than 700 million years into the future. So are there things that we can do that can help mitigate some of these extremes on Mars and provide a better environment for science and exploration to coexist on the surface? To look at the tools that we currently have to be able to understand the physics of what's going on. That's what planetary scientists do when we model. We're going to link the heliophysics models that have progressed extremely well in analyzing and understanding space weather with our Mars global climate modeling activity. Use that to create a dipole field at Mars L1. Why would we do that? Well, we want to investigate how that affects the stripping that goes on. Now, this is not terraforming as we may think about it, where we actually artificially change the climate, but we let nature do it, and we do that based on the physics that we know today. This tells us that perhaps we don't have all the physics in the models that we need. We have a little more work to do in this area.